These recent violent crimes have left people in many communities across the metro searching for answers that answer the question why? What's the cause of all of this? While also searching for ways to heal from the trauma these incidents leave behind.
From a 12-year-old shot and killed in North Minneapolis to a mass shooting in a St. Paul nightclub, it's been a traumatic few weeks for communities across the Twin Cities with lingering impacts.
I had the shakes all morning just thinking about it and what if. And our friends.
But even for those who may not have witnessed these tragedies,
communal trauma is a very real thing.
Clinical psychologists say in one way or another, these incidents impact us all in ways we may or may not realize in the moment.
There's a term called disenfranchised grief. And what that means is despite not being there or being present for these events, it still impacts our own mental health and our community's mental health.
And the impacts can vary.
We might decide that the only safe place for us is home and we isolate. We might notice that our heart starts racing a lot more when we walk into public areas and places that we used to see as very safe and relaxing can now turn into areas of stress.
Mental health experts say part of overcoming the trauma associated with disenfranchised grief is first being able to validate your own feelings.
A lot of times we minimize that and we say, no, I can't feel this way. I have to be strong for my community.
But part of that strength involves seeking help when needed.
Whether it's verbally, like I said, through talk therapy, or, you know, a lot of people find comfort in writing down what happened and then being able to share that with a provider or a therapist. And that can be really empowering for people that have gone through traumatic events.
Now, clinical psychologists say it's okay to take your time easing back into the way life used to be before whatever traumatic event took place in order to avoid reaching burnout. Julie?
Well, I know she's right, Devon. I know a lot of us feel sadness and anxiety and exhaustion from all the crime we've seen lately. Thanks
Indeed.
So much.